Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss how to find the true length of a given line and inclination with reference planes. Here the line is given, PQ line. We need to find the length of this line. Okay, length is not given, we need to find total length. The total length we can call it as true length. Okay. And also we need to find the angle with reference plane. How much this line is making angle with the horizontal plane and angle with the vertical plane. Okay. Now here the given data is a straight line PQ has its end P 20 mm above the HP and 30 mm in front of VP. Okay, one end is P, the end P position has given. Okay, and the end Q, this is end Q. It is 80 mm above the HP and 70 mm in front of VP. The position of P point, the position of Q point has given. Okay, here the end projectors are 6 cm apart. If you are taking P position, P dash P, it is in the front view. In the top view, it is small P. In the front view it is Q dash, in the top view it is Q. The line joining P dash and P is, we can call it as projector, and the line joining Q dash and Q is coming on the same line, it is called projector. The distance between projector has given, it is 6 cm. Okay, and then draw the projections of the line. We need to draw the front view of this line and top view of this line. Now after this we have to find, determine its true length. We need to find the total length of the line and also true inclination with the reference planes. We need to find the angle, how much angle this line is making with the horizontal plane and how much angle it is making with the vertical plane. Okay, first write the given data. After that you will take the position of this line and from the front view and top view we can find the true length of the line. Here I have written the given data. P point is 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of VP, and the Q is 80 mm above HP and 70 mm in front of VP. For showing the position of these two, I am taking, this is a vertical plane, this is a horizontal plane, and the angle between these two planes is 90 degrees, and the line joining both planes is XY line. We can call it as reference line also. Actually this is the first quadrant. Okay, like this. Now I am keeping this for showing the line according to our convenient. Okay, this is the given line. We don't know the length of this line. Okay, this is P, this is Q. P is 20 mm above HP. So this is a horizontal plane. The gap between P and horizontal plane is 20 mm, and then it is 30 mm in front of VP. This P point is 30 mm in front of VP. Okay, so first mark P position in both front view and top view. Okay, in the front view if we see from this side, okay, first we can see this gap, 20 mm gap. After that we can see this P point on the vertical plane. Okay, in the front view we can see the image of front view on the vertical plane. Okay, first I will mark P dash point. So take here about 20 mm, we can see the front view. For front views we are taking small letters with dash. Okay, this is a front view of P point, and this is gap also, it is 30 mm in front of VP. Okay, so in the top view we can see this gap, 30 mm gap, and this P point on the horizontal plane. Okay, now here we can take same projector line. Okay, 30 mm gap, we can see small P. Okay, this is a front view, this is a top view. Now this is a 3D view. We are tilting this horizontal plane in downward direction like this, so that we can see both views on the same paper. It is called 2D view. Okay, after marking P dash P position, Q position has also given. Okay, before marking Q position, it has given end projector distance is 60 mm, that is 6 cm. It has given in the question. Okay, the end projectors are 6 cm apart. Okay, P dash P is one projector. And similarly Q dash Q also coming on the same line. The line distance between this projector is 6 cm. Okay, so just mark 6 cm from this line. Just do one line. We have to mark Q dash Q according to the given position. Okay, for marking the Q position, take here, planes are in 3D form like this. So this is the P point, already we did. And Q is 80 mm above HP. This is Q point, this is P point. It is 80 mm above horizontal plane. Okay, and then 70 mm in front of VP. This gap is, okay, from vertical plane it is 70 mm. This is 80 and this is 70. Okay, in the front view we can see the Q dash on the vertical plane. How much gap it is? It is 80 mm above HP. Okay, so after 80 mm we can see the Q dash on the vertical plane. It is called front view. So just mark here. So above XY line 80 mm gap. Mark Q dash. Just we did one line here, so on it take 8 cm. Okay, so after that we have marked q dash point, and q dash is the front view. For marking the top view, we have to see the q point here. So this is q is 70 mm from the vertical plane. In the top view, we can see this q point and this 70 also. Okay, so on the same projector line, mark q. So this is the top view, we can see on the vertical plane. So already we did the line. From this, take 70 mm. Mark Q point. After getting P point and Q point position, this is the final front view. If you join P dash Q dash, this is the final front view. This is the final top view. If you join this point to this point, it is the final top view. But these lengths are less than the true length of the line. We need to find the length of true length of the line. First we do in the sheet. Okay, after that we will find the true length. Take the XY line of any length. Already I did one XY line here. Mark the P position and Q position accordingly. So after doing the XY line, mark P dash P. It is 20 and 30 this side. So already I have 20 here, P dash point, and here 30 means at 5 cm P point. Okay, this is 3 cm. Just do one line here, projector line. So mark P dash and P, small P dash, small P. After that, take 6 cm gap from this projector line. So here mark Q dash and Q, okay, on this projector line. Okay, take this is the reference line. So at this point, 6 cm from this line, just tilt the roller scale and mark Q dash 8 cm above the XY line. So 8 cm above the XY line, mark this point here, Q dash. And here below 7 cm, mark Q. Okay. So 7 cm means it is coming here, mark Q point. Okay, join Q dash and Q with projector line. So this gap is 6 cm. Already we kept the gap 6 cm. Okay. Now after that, join P dash, Q dash, small P, small Q. It is a final front view and final top view. After getting this rough diagram, here just do locus of Q point in the front view, locus of Q point in the top view. Because if we are tilting this line, okay, whatever angle, this point is moving on the same plane. Okay, plane means it is looking like line in the both front view and top view. Okay, locus of Q point. After take this is the reference line. At Q dash, do the locus of Q point. And similarly at Q also, both Q dash and Q, we did the locus of Q point. After that, we need to find the true length of the line by using this data. As I told, this line is making angle with horizontal plane as well as vertical plane like this. So this line in the top view, it is looking like this. By using this, we need to find the true length. What I am taking is whatever angle it is making with vertical plane, so I am taking that angle is 0. 0 means I am keeping this line parallel to this vertical plane. Okay, previously it is making some angle here. Okay, but I am taking this line is 0 degrees angle, that is parallel to the vertical plane like this. Okay, so whatever length is there, I am tilting this length up to this P point. Okay, just do the line here up to some length. Take this length by using compass, just do tilt it like this so that it is parallel to the vertical plane. So take this by using compass, we are centered, do an arc here. Okay, now we are tilting like this. So in the front view, we can see the true length of the line. Okay, whatever we are tilting, okay, at this position, we can see the true length of the line. Because it is parallel to VP, in the front view, we can see this length. Okay, here, just do the line. Because same length, we can see in the front view. Okay, so this top view, we are tilting, Q1 it is. If we extend this line, we will get the intersection point on the locus line. If you join P dash, Q1 dash, it is the true length of the line. Okay, in the front view. Above the XY line, it is the front view. Below the XY line, it is the top view. Similarly, after getting the true length in the front view, we have to get the true length in the top view also. Initially, the front view is P dash, Q dash. Okay, it is looking, the line position is like this. From it, we have to find the true length in the top view. Okay, so this is like this. What we are doing, whatever front view is here, we have to tilt in this direction. So whatever angle it is making with horizontal, we have to assume it is parallel to the horizontal plane. That is, whatever this angle, it is 0 degrees. We are making 0 degrees. Whatever this front view is here, okay, final front view, we have to tilt in the downward direction. So same as like this, so that in the top view we can see the true length of the line. Okay, so whatever front view is here at P dash, just do the line by using compass, tilt this final top view in this direction. Okay, here by using compass, and take this is Q2 dash. Okay. Now drop this line, because in the top view we can see the true length. Okay, so the same whatever length we did here, take the same length here, do vertical line up to this locus point. Take this intersection point is here, we have given Q2 dash, here give Q2. Join this P point to Q2 with the help of scale. This length PQ2 is the true length. Okay, in the top view. And P dash Q1 dash is the true length in the front view. Okay, if you measure these two values by using scale, we will get the same length. Okay, so do the same thing in the sheet also for getting the true length. So by using this compass, we can take this length, front view length. Okay, we are just tilting up to this horizontal line. Okay, so this is the true length in the front view after tilting. Take this intersection point is Q2 dash, because we are keeping dash for all the front views. Okay, just do the line for getting this length, total length. As I told, okay, we are tilting whatever front view is there, we are tilting in this direction. So in the front view we are seeing this line. Okay, this line. Now in the top view also we are seeing the same length, whatever length here, we are taking the same length by doing the line up to this locus point. Just at Q2 dash, just do the line. Okay, in the front view we are giving Q2 dash, means in the top view we have to give Q2. Okay, just join P and Q2. Okay, you can see that line from the top. So if you see this line in the top, it is a true length, we can see. Okay, so this is the true length of the line if you join P and Q2. So this length is called true length. We can measure by using the scale. It is approximately 9.5 centimeters. Okay, so true length of the line is 9.5 centimeter. This is in the top view. Okay, we need to do the true length in the front view also. For getting it, we have to follow the same procedure. Whatever top view is there, final top view, this P, whatever length is there, we have to tilt in this direction. How to take this length? By using the compass up to this, take this intersection point is Q1. Whatever length is there top view, we are tilting here. Okay, after getting it, do a vertical line here at Q1. Just do the line. It is touching at, this is Q1, this is Q1 dash. Okay, join P dash Q1 dash, it is the true length in the front view. Okay, so above XY line, these are the front views. Below XY line, these are the top views. By using scale, join P dash Q1 dash. Now measure this length, it should also same as this length, because true length of the line is same in both front view and top view. It should be 9.5. So here we are getting same as 9.5 centimeter in both front view and top view. And also we have to find true inclination with the reference planes. We need to find this angle. Okay, this true length is making how much angle with the HP, and this true length is making how much angle with the VP. By using the protractor, we can measure the values. So here it is making 40 degrees. Okay, just mark here, this is making 40 degrees. Keep sharp arrows here. This angle, true length. And here also true length is making angle. We can find by keeping the protractor like this. It is 25 degrees. Okay, so mark here, just keep an arc and arrows. This angle is 25 degrees. Okay, and mark other dimensions also. Here mark the dimensions, given dimensions. This P point is 20 mm above HP. So do the dimensional line, at least 1 cm gap here. This is 20 and 30 mm in front of VP. This is 30 and then Q is 8 mm above HP. Already I did the dimensional line. It is CT and then 70 mm in front of VP and this is 70. The distance between end projectors is 60 mm. Okay, here I have marked inside the diagram. You can take this dimension. You can mark outside the diagram also. Okay, you have to extend this line and this line. You can mark 60 here. Okay, so this is the process of finding the true length of the line as well as true inclination with HP and VP. Okay, if you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.